The broad and deep heart and love of a mother are like the ocean, the giver of life that embraces and purifies all things. In this spirit, the Women's Federation for World Peace aims to foster true freedom, peace, and happiness in our world. Overcoming suffering throughout the ages, nurturing the lives of others, our daughters, wives, and mothers have been gentle yet strong, delicate yet upright. The exemplary faith and love of women has the power to awaken a world of peace and harmony for all people. The dawning of the era of women was proclaimed in April 1992. Those women who embraced this vision of peace and joined the Women's Federation's efforts did not just come together to pursue the rights and interests of women alone. It has been a remarkable undertaking, with women seeking to spread the energy of peace and harmony around the world, based on true motherly love. Standing at the center of this are Reverend Sun Myung Moon and his wife, Dr. Hak Ja Han Moon, the founders of the Women's Federation for World Peace. Reverend and Mrs. Moon have awakened people's original minds and natures and led them to practice love, justice, courtesy, and wisdom in this world. They have revealed God's heart and will and led us on the path to becoming God's children and to becoming pillars in the work for peace. They are referred to as the true parents of humankind, as true teachers, and as the king and queen of peace. In the 3 months following WFWP's inauguration, Dr. Hak Ja Han Moon led women's rallies in 113 cities in all corners of the world, on every continent. Her passionate heart created the strong root for the Women's Federation's global activities.
Healing young children in Gaza, Iranians in Iraqis in Jordan. I want to try to inspire them towards really living for the sake of others, to live going beyond their enmity.
For the past 18 years, since its first meeting in Istanbul in May 1997, WFWP's Women's Conference for Peace in the Middle East has strived to sow seeds of harmony and peace in the conflict-torn parts of that region. In addition, sisterhood ceremonies, which were first held between 160,000 Korean and Japanese women in 1994, have expanded to bring together women of different races and religions, leading to expanding expressions of harmony, surmounting the barriers between nations, peoples, ideologies, and cultures. The solidarity and cooperation fostered through the WFWP International Leaders workshops and conferences, which have been held in different regions, are nurturing the ideal of a peaceful world. The reunification of Korea would be a shortcut to a world of harmony. Over two decades, WFWP has led initiatives for the reunification of the Koreas based on the philosophy of true love proposed by Reverend and Mrs. Moon. At the beginning of each year, in January, WFWP holds a prayer event to pray for the unification of the two Koreas and for world peace. The Women's Federation has had exchanges with North Korean women leaders since the year 2000 and has opened up genuine avenues of discussion on issues of reunification. Through sisterhood ceremonies with North Korean refugees, supporting their education in alternative schools, the 1% Love Share Project for North Korea, and other activities, WFWP plays a significant role in supporting families in the North. WFWP is planting the vision of a unified Korea in the hearts of children and awakening the call for reunification among women leaders. Relying on the harmony and love that flows from the heart of a mother, the Women's Federation members put aside ideological differences so that the people of the Korean Peninsula can become one family again. In August 1994, WFWP in Japan commissioned 1,600 full-time volunteers among 160 countries of the world. These volunteers began schools for children and adult education for women, teaching them skills to enable them to stand on their own feet. They became mothers and sisters to those suffering from disease, hunger, and poverty in remote areas of the world. The schools WFWP established made education more widely available, and students in difficult situations were helped through foster parenting and scholarship programs. WFWP volunteers also carried out AIDS prevention education in areas most affected. Through the 1% Love Share initiative to help women and children suffering from poverty and disease around the world, WFWP has been practicing true love that embraces the world as one family. In September 1993, Dr. Hak-ja Han Moon gave an official speech at the United Nations headquarters in New York. She was the first Asian woman to do so. Her speech emphasized that the morality of exemplary families and social morality are the basis for world peace. The work of the WFWP chapters she founded worldwide led to the UN's decision to designate WFWP an NGO, having general consultative status with its Economic and Social Council. WFWP has maintained that status, passing the UN evaluation held every 4 years. The organization has initiated many international projects geared to supporting the realization of the UN Millennium Development Goals.
It is a great honor and pleasure for me to address this important forum on the occasion of the 20th anniversary of the Women's Federation for World Peace International.
The head of the United Nations NGO section commended the Women's Federation, which celebrated its 20th anniversary in 2012, in its quest to create a turning point in the global efforts for peace. A historic convention was held on July 16, 2012. Reverend and Mrs. Sun Myung-moon held the inaugural assembly for the Global Women's Peace Network, which they ambitiously refer to as the ABLE Women UN. The ABLE Women UN aims to build the collaboration and solidarity of women worldwide on many issues. It encourages the active participation of women in the United Nations. As WFWP celebrated its 20th anniversary, it embraced this greater vision and strengthened its determination to move forward without rest.
더 덕력 하늘에 찬란하게 떠오르는 태양과 함께 이제 천운이 온누리를 비치고 있습니다. 수천 수만 년간 덮였던 어둠의 장막이 마침내 걷히고 있습니다. 여러분의 가슴 속에 벌써 천명의 뿌리를 내리고 있습니다. 피할 수 없는 숙명일입니다.
The Women's Federation for World Peace is striving to embrace the world with the broad and deep heart of a mother. As one family, WFWP seeks to care for those who are in pain and suffering, and to reach out to embrace those who are isolated as a result of conflict. There is no fear, no stepping back in WFWP's peace initiatives. There is only a harmonious way that opens people's hearts by bringing down barriers through unceasing understanding and sharing. This is the fertile soil in which the hopes for world peace will blossom.